up?
How you doing, bro?
You ready to go to the zoo?
Yeah, let's go to the zoo.
What animal are you looking forward to seeing?
The Bradley Potamus.
So we're here now at the zoo, here with Eric.
What's up?
We're still not sure what we're training, but it's gonna be epic.
Great to smell.
Yeah, it smells kind of weird in the parking lot, but let's see how it smells inside. It was a long drive, though, but let's see. The sun is in the way. Let me get some shade action. That sun is blocking the whole shit. All right, there you go. Zoo culture.
What do you think we're going to train? Let's take a look real quick and see if it's better. Arms or shoulders. I actually got to take a piss real quick.
All right.
You want to, let's go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Let's go to the bathroom.
Papers on the floor.
Oh, it smells good though. I got you there.
It smells really good, yeah.
It smells really good in there.
Toilet is clean.
Toilet nice, squeaky.
9 out of 10 bathroom.
Toilet protected. Oh, they have a scale in the bathroom.
Oh, oh shit.
Wow, that's impressive. Let's see. This is good. Good bathroom service, man.
250.4.
With no sleep. 250 with no sleep. All right. I gotta get started.
Yeah, I think you gotta tap on it.
Okay. Is it broke?
257. Okay. Shit, I'm catching up again.
Yeah, you're catching up.
Didn't you outweigh me in the last video by like 30 pounds?
Yeah, right. I think I was like 260, right? Right.
Yeah. Alright. This loses 1 point, otherwise, 9 out of 10 bathroom. Because you have the lighting, dude, the lighting in here.
Lighting is awesome. They got Eric. In case you know, you have to do some business.
9.5 out of 10. I didn't notice that.
Look at this. Look at this. Fucking very environment friendly right here. Oh, recycling all the bottles and cans. But it's overfilled with them, so.
So you'll give that a
9.3. Testing out. Is it cold?
Is it cold? Wow, it's actually really cold.
What do you give that?
I give that a 9.5.
9.5.
Let me test this one out. For the little people. Not as cold as the tall people.
Oh.
Is that discrimination? The tall one is colder.
The short people have to drink warm water.
Nine,
it's because Bradley's tall.
Yeah, that's right.
That's
short one. Short one gets a 9, the other one gets a 9.5.
Okay. And let's see what the temperature is. 74 degrees, what do you think?
74 degrees.
That's pretty nice to train
not
in.
Pretty good.
Not too 10. Cold.
I give that a 10.
A 10?
Solid 10.
I would make it a little colder. I get hot easily, so.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Maybe a 9 out of 10. The music is so loud here.
The music is so loud, you can't hear yourself talk, but the music choice, I like it. It's good high music. It's a little louder than I wanted. Let's say an 8. I'll give it an 8 out of 10. How about you?
I'll give it a 7 for the volume, but a 9 for the music selection.
Hey.
Yeah.
When I had it on 70?
60. Oh, you had it 80, I think. No, 70, yeah.
Yeah, it's heavy. It looks easy, but it's not. Yep. Arm day. At the zoo. Yep.
Oh, do the dance.
Thank you.
guys. Take a look at this. 10 out of 10 to sticking to his word.
Yeah. Looking big as fuck.
Damn, bro.
These stacks are way heavier, way heavier.
Than Bill's Venice?
Yeah.
What do you rate the heaviness?
11 out of 10.
11 out of 10. They have this right here to keep everything clean. Uh-huh. In case the equipment ever gets dirty, you know, I like that. 10 out of 10.
All
right, so what do you think about what just happened?
I'm not sure.
There was just a hobo in here in the bathroom for like an hour, and now Bradley just kicked him out. He's gotta go. So this gym is 10 out of 10 at keeping hobos out.
I give the hobo a
10 out of 10 security.
I love you guys. No matter what. That's
do you love me?
Yeah.
Hug it out, man. Hug it out.
This is a big dude. It's kinda weird that we're doing this.
It's a good thumbnail though.
It is. Nah, but like I don't know, kinda like what we talked about earlier. Like life is short.
Right.
Like as far as like holding on to grudges or holding on to like anger or like resentment and things like that, I think like we could all learn that it really does nothing good. It does no good for me, it does no good for anyone, for you. And I could say for sure there was moments over the last year that like I kinda let what happened really bother me. And I was like, yo, I know that I didn't do these things, but people kinda like made it something that it wasn't. And but I also realized, and this is what's really important, that's why you talked about the motivational thing earlier. I got it now. No matter what, right? What you do, you may not, your intention may not to be like for something to happen, right? You may have like really good intentions, but people's perspectives are always different, right? So what you're doing, at the end of the day, if you get yourself into a situation, you still got yourself there somehow. Whether or not like your intentions were good, your intentions were bad, whatever, it's like, I could be upset that like I got somewhere, someone said something about me, but the reality is like I still got myself in that position and at least close enough for someone to say something about me. So that's the thing is like, for sure stuff's not true, right? And I'm sure stuff can be said about you that's not true. And anyone you're listening, for sure. And the reality is like, if people wanna believe it, it's fine. But the truth is, and this is what I'm trying to get the point across, is like, wherever you're at, like whatever you have going on, if something's going on and shit in your life, like you still got yourself there somehow. Like whether or not like, something was said about you and you did it or not, you still got yourself in a situation with people or things that could be an outcome. You know what I'm saying? And I learned straight up that like, at the end of the day, that's still my fucking choice. Right. That was still my choice that I made to like, be able to end up in that situation. Yeah. So, because if people always go like, and I did this when shit used to happen to me, like I'd be like, why me? Like I didn't do these things, why me? But it doesn't, it's like, I still got myself there somehow. So I guess I'm trying to say, guys, like whatever you have going on, good, bad, whatever, you don't matter. Like, look at your actions and things that got you to where you are in your life, and just understand that like, someone else's fault but your own.
I don't expect it. What about your boy right here? Behind the camera. Okay, you're so, Kevin.
My Kevin.
Yeah.
So, what are your thoughts on this? He's going to be the first natural bodybuilder to win nationals. What do you think about that?
Nationals,
yeah.
Oh, he's gonna be first natural?
Yeah. Oh, I don't think any natural has won it before. I mean,
in physique,
there's Jeff's
side and stuff, but...
Oh, they're all natural, right?
Right, yeah.
Oh.
But in bodybuilding, I don't think there's been, like, any naturals who look like this, you know? Have you ever seen a better natural physique?
Yo, this is too funny right now. Yeah. This guy's natural.
Well, he is.
He's amazing. You're amazing, bro.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it, man.
Just like, it's amazing. Like, I teach me.
It's hard work, man. It's hard work.
He eats a lot of bumpy fats.
How many?
I get like 50 grams a day.
50 grams?
All natural peanut butter.
Peanut butter?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All natural.
That's a secret. Oh, that's how. I got it. Mm-hmm. It's the natural peanut butter.
A lot of people are more about like protein and carbs. They neglect the healthy fats. So.
Yeah, so it's like you just got to have the natural peanut butter in like a really good light.
Exactly.
Like,
there you go.
Natty Lottie with the natty peanut butter. Mm-hmm. And then,
exactly. And you look like this.
Cool. How long you been natty for, bro?
I've been natty for going on 10 years now.
It's funny because yo, you're stupid. Oh, God, these conversations.
He's
hilarious.
Actually 10 years old.
Like the most I can eat is like 6 meals, 7 meals.
These days, barely even 3 or 4 sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, that's how I am right now, too. Yeah. For damn sure. My appetite is like...
How the shoe game? Huh? How the shoe game?
Duck boots?
Oh, there you go.
Duck boots?
The shoe game?
Yeah. Yeah, these are called duck boots. They're not made out of ducks.